we interview people that know the artists. We read everything we can. And in the case of Andy Warhol, although he had died before we wrote that biography, but we were both so interested in Andy's work and think he is probably one of the most important artists of the last 50 years of the 20th century. But he, everybody who knew Andy wrote a book about him, and he wrote books too, and everybody made up stories, including Andy. And so it was up to us doing that research to kind of weed through this morass of information and misinformation to write a book about an artist who often in an interview session would not even answer the question, just nod his head or say yes and no. So
he had his dealer answer for him in one interview.
Yeah.
Yes.
He was a really strange but marvelous character, and probably one of the first artists that we knew that became a celebrity just because he was a great character. But the art was iconic.
Well, they did always say he'd go to the opening of an envelope, and indeed he was all over New York. You couldn't live in New York in those years and not see Andy someplace or other.
And he went on a tour, and my husband Ronnie has an art gallery in St. Louis, and it was 1975, and he gave a Warhol show. And Andy came to St. Louis for the show with his entourage and came to our house for a big party. I think it was a Monday night in St. Louis. We invited 90 people and 120 came. It was really an event. And I am not proud to tell you this, but I had young children in Campbell soup cans in my pantry. And all our guests who could find their way to the pantry would grab the soup cans and ask him to autograph them, which he was happy to do. In fact, he was happier signing than talking. And it was really one of the great moments that we remember from those early years, those heady years. And who knew then that I would end up writing a book with Sandra about Andy? But I felt as if I was revisiting an old friend.